Now, if you're trying to get in touch with a human being, you probably have a lot of different options. You can call them on the phone, you can send them an email, text message, etc., communicator, whatever. And that's the same thing with these contacts that we see here in notifications. By default, when you're working with Active Directory, you'll notice that there is a delivery endpoint called email that just kind of comes along for the ride with Active Directory. And I can add more to that, though. So for example, if there's an alternate email, both his work email and his home email, I can just go into Bob's record here, his contact information, and choose a new delivery endpoint. And that new delivery endpoint can be a variety of different options here. Well, a variety of two. By default, it can be email or a web service, and each one has its own configuration elements. Now, there is a third one that's available for download. You won't find it here by default. It's the Office Communications Server plugin. That's basically a new delivery channel that will allow you to get in touch with somebody via communicator. So, you know, these are the different types of ways you can communicate with people through notifications. And if you've got some wonderful whiz-bang application, you know, that's even better than all these, you're going to use Twitter or you're going to use Facebook postings or whatever, and you develop that on your own, we've got hooks into adding that as a new delivery channel. Now, that's way beyond the scope of this class, but if you're interested in that, please give us a contact us at training@osisoft.com. We'll point you in the right direction. There's some good examples of creating your own delivery channels that we can share with you if you're interested. Okay, I want to undo what I just created there. Undo that checkout. Yeah, there we go. Now also, you can go into this section here, this contact section, and create a brand new delivery endpoint that is not associated with any contact. That's actually fairly useful for things that are programmatic, like web services. You know, sometimes there may be something that you would like to route a notification to it, but there's no real contact involved. Okay, so let's take a look at some of the options that are available to you when you do configure a new delivery endpoint. Let me go ahead and create a new delivery endpoint for Bob Smith. As you can see, there's these standard options you see here. One of them is called Notify on Close, and what that means is that we're simply going to notify, or we're going to trigger this delivery if there is no longer the conditions that triggered this notification. It's essentially the notification's closed, so we let people know. There's also the option to have this retry, and you can retry at a certain maximum number of retries with an interval specified here as, you know, minutes, seconds, days, etc. So these are some of the standard options every delivery endpoint will have, whether it's going to be email or a web service. And then, of course, you can specify what type of delivery channel you want this delivery endpoint to use as its mechanism for communicating. As I said, that is extensible. And you can right now, today, download the Office Communicator Server or Office Communications Server delivery channel and use that as well to communicate this using Communicator. Well, as you can see, each delivery channel is going to have its own configuration items. This is the email delivery channel, and so naturally we specify the, you know, the communication information here. Let's go with, this is bsmith@hotmail.com. as his email address, and then what we're specifying this from email for is simply saying everybody who receives this notification is going to get it from that user. And if you choose global, that's the global configuration. This can be custom for per email. And then finally, we do have the priority. Oh, by the way, here's one last thing I forgot to show you, is this option here. It's in the newer version of notification. I just noticed I was running an older version, so I've just updated to the latest release. As you can see, you can choose the format that you want in addition to that that priority like we saw before. Now lastly, we have this field as to whether we include that acknowledgement link in the email body itself. And you can either say yes or no. Now this only with standard input will make a little bit more sense later on when we take a look at the standard content options that are available within the specifying the content in your notification. This is basically saying if you've chosen this elsewhere to include standard content, then you would in fact include it here. And this would override that other setting. So that would say yes in all instances. So that's the default, and we'll just go ahead and keep that. Now, don't miss the little test button over here. This is going to allow you to go ahead and test that, see if your SMTP server is working and configured properly. And might as well mention it now. If it doesn't work, then by all means, go back to your notification section here. Go into Tools, Notification Settings, and look under the Delivery Channels. And this is where that SMTP server setting is set.